Huge news. As of yesterday, Don Lemon said he might quit, that he doesn't know if he can withstand the toxicity and stay on the air through the 2020 election. If you thought things were crazy now with the Vox adpocalypse, with all the censorship we're seeing, just wait until we are in full swing election season. My God, it is going to be a nightmare. It's going to be equal parts nightmarish, dystopian, kind of hilarious. You got to admit, there's some really funny things that sometimes happen that make me just confused. But I'll add one thing, you know? Don't be stressed about all of this news and toxicity. Don't be stressed. Because I was thinking about this the other day, and I'm like, man, everyone's losing their minds. You know, Vox is destroying people's careers. There is a dude who makes YouTube videos of relaxing noise. I kid you not, it's an amazing channel. He films like this really amazing beach scene with like a little shack on the water, and you hear raindrops and ocean sounds. They demonetize this guy. Vox adpocalypse. But you know what? I thought, while there are people being negatively impacted in serious ways, at least life isn't boring. Like, what would we be doing if nothing was happening? So it's fun. But let's get to the story. Let's not ramble on these other issues. CNN host Don Lemon doubts his ability to withstand toxicity and stay in the air through 2020 election. Don Lemon, who has been on CNN since, this is from Deadline, he's been on CNN since 2006, says the toxicity of social media and the balkanized vocal state of the nation in the Trump era make him uncertain whether he will remain on the air doing his current show through the 2020 election. I gotta say, though, I can absolutely sympathize with what Don Lemon is talking about. Now, I personally have no respect for the man for a variety of reasons. One, he asked if a black hole could swallow a plane. He reported there was no tear gas as I was being tear gassed. I took that one kind of personally. Do your job. Don't just espouse nonsense when people are being hurt. Okay, so that was not necessarily personal, but I take a great issue with him doing that. But he's right. I mean, things are really crazy right now. People are mean, nasty. There's just chaos. It is a war. It is an information war, if I would. But Don Lemon goes on to tell a story. He says, I was doing a shoot in the park the other day, and someone shouted at me, I'm sick of watching you. We built this country. I can't wait for CNN to fire your black A. UF. He recalled Thursday during a keynote session at the FT Future of News Summit. So all of those sorts of people call you on the phone and say those things, or they write you, I don't go on social media anymore. It's so toxic. Well, you know what, Don? Spot on. I completely agree. I really, really do. There was a point where I actually deleted Twitter from my phone a few months ago. And I realized that was probably a really stupid thing to do. Because as much as I've absolutely said in the past, like, ban Twitter and I'm going to stop using it, I've started using it again for a variety of reasons. But I will say this, I use it more in a passive kind of just, it is very toxic. It is. And I'm not going to act like I'm better than anybody else on the platform. I certainly bring the negativity too. And that's the problem. Think about it. There was this report I was reading that's the other day from the video I made. When people used to get angry about things, it was local events. Now everyone's getting angry about everything, and everyone's always pissed off. And I'm included. We all are. I mean, no one's immune to this. So Don Lemon's right. And I can certainly empathize with him saying he wants to quit. Now, I am going to do something real quick and say, go to timcast.com/donate if you want to support my work. Or just like and comment on the video. I'll try to keep these little plugs shorter, but it really is important with all the chaos and demonetization and people being taken out. Timcast.com/donate. Donate, like, comment, share the video, subscribe. Moderator Matthew Guerin, news editor for the Financial Times, relayed an audience question posted online, wondering whether Lemon would stay on the air despite it all. I don't know, he said. I absolutely love what I do, but I wonder how long I want to do this particular job in the way that I do it. He later clarified, it doesn't mean that I don't have a commitment to journalism. It just means that I may want to do it in a different way. Whoa, hold on. I disagree with you there. You've never had a commitment to journalism. And don't take my word for it. I love this stuff. Don Lemon named worst journalism of 2014 list. Bravo, buddy. Don Lemon was not only named worst journalist in 2014, this from The Hollywood Reporter, but someone actually launched a petition that got nearly 40,000 signatures to remove Don Lemon from CNN. Don is still, in my opinion, the worst. Well, maybe not the worst, but he's very tepid, but bad. And he said a bunch of really offensive things. He said a bunch of racist things. I used to have CNN playing in the background all the time, just because it's kind of like, I don't know how you describe CNN. CNN, it's a news channel. So when news breaks, there'd be something on the channel. But Don Lemon, I watched several segments where he repeated really racist things. And as all of you know, I absolutely take issue with hate speech. I absolutely take offense to targeting people based on certain characteristics. But I don't believe he should be removed from his position. I just think I will take the free market approach and turn off your channel, right? Maybe Carlos Maza could have said, I'm going to stop listening to this because, you know, this guy's saying mean things about me. That's my approach. You know what, CNN? I turn you off because Don Lemon is trash. I'm not going to call and demand they remove anybody or anything like that. But I don't watch it anymore because Don Lemon is trash. And he says overtly racist things all the time. So, you know, I will say this. There's fault to go around for everybody being so toxic. But Don Lemon's show is not journalism, period. And I think I have another story here. Yes, Don Lemon, CNN host Don Lemon says his show and his network are not liberal. Oh, please. Absolutely not. The New York Times said you were. Don Lemon, you know, if he quits, I think it'll be funny. I do not believe, I believe, actually, there's a certain catharsis there. It would be funny, and I'd let out a deep chortle if he did quit. But I actually don't want him to. I do not want Don Lemon to quit. I do not want Don Lemon off the air. Don Lemon is entitled to his voice. If CNN wants to give him that position, they're absolutely allowed to. And I do not in any way want anyone to be censored, no matter what. There's certain limitations. I shouldn't say no matter what. That's too absolutist. But I just turn off CNN when I have a problem with Don Lemon. So, no. He thinks his show is not liberal. Well, Don Lemon, you're wrong. Actually, let's finish up the first story and we'll come back to this one. They say, while the 20-minute session touched on a few other topics, Lemon's misgivings about the current era in cable news and popular political culture proved a dominant theme. Lemon said the lack of personal safety has taken a toll. At least 53? Whoa, I thought Don Lemon was like early 40s, late 30s. Damn. At 53, the host of a two-hour nightly show on CNN said he has become concerned about the changes in his day-to-day reactions. Not only sparring with guests and pushing back on the Trump administration, but being a what Garen described as a unicorn. An openly gay black host in primetime has made him an unusually big target. Well, Anderson Cooper's openly gay too. And he's a silver fox. It's kind of like a mirror image. I'm such a gregarious person, he said. No, you're not. Take that back. That insults gregarians. Gregorians? When people would come up to me, I would give them a hug. I don't do that anymore because you don't know what someone's motives are. Somebody could accuse me of making them uncomfortable or being inappropriate with them or touching them inappropriately. Whoa, Don Lemon slamming me too. Now we're getting crazy. When someone asks me for a selfie, I say, do you mind if I put my arm around you? I am very careful about that and I shouldn't be, but that's where we are. Yeah, Don Lemon, you're right. You're right. You know what? You know what? I want to be nice to Don Lemon at this point. He's brought up some really important points. He's bringing up the Me Too issues of, like, you can't even touch people anymore. I agree. I think it's really weird. Yeah, you can put your arm around somebody and make physical contact with a person without being inappropriate. Human beings touch each other. Like, not every touch is the bad touch. And he also brings up really good points about toxicity. So you know what? Don Lemon deserves some credit here. Absolutely. I still think he's trash, for sure. But I always want to make sure I give credit where credit is due. And so if I had a scale of 0 to 100, with 100 being the best, 100 points out of 100 and 0 being the worst, Don Lemon was at a 0, and now he's at a 10. Congratulations. I'm not saying Don Lemon should care about my opinion, by no means. He added, everything catches up with you. I don't know if I can deal with this level of toxicity for so long. Lemon did show many flashes of humor during the conversation. He recalled getting invited to a celebrity cooking event hosted by Bobby Flay. He remembered thinking, my gosh, this is so refreshing. I didn't have to talk about the president. I didn't have to talk politics. I just had to judge someone's hamburger. I completely empathize and sympathize with that sentiment, which is why I'm building the van and I'm going to go up to the mountains and go fishing. I'm still going to be recording videos. That's the point of the van, mobile production. And it will also allow me to be on the ground and cover various news stories. But you know what? I want to make sure I say, spot on, Don Lemon, spot on. I don't like you professionally. I have nothing against you personally, except for that issue where you said there was no tear gas in Ferguson. Professionally, I think you're bad. I think CNN is bad. I think your show is overly liberal. You are wrong. But I'd have no problem sitting down with a burger and talking about anything with you or anyone else. So I will clarify, and I hope everyone else feels this way, that we can separate political, you know, arguments and professional arguments from being humans and recognizing we all live together. And what I've seen here from Mr. Lemon is agreeable. It's absolutely agreeable. It is too toxic. Don's right. It is way too toxic. I have played my part in that. Most of us have. And I don't know what the solution is, other than just like lighting social media up and just getting rid of it. I mean that metaphorically, please, metaphorically. God, you never know what people are going to do when they pull that stuff up. Old quotes. But I think, you know, things are way too toxic and it weighs on you. The Vox Adpocalypse is just so much negativity. For those that aren't familiar, like people getting just wiped out. We have to, like, you know, here's the thing. It's a cycle of hate. Strike Through, Carlos Maza, makes videos targeting conservatives. In response, conservative Steven Crowder fires back and mocks him. In response to this, Carlos Maza fires an all-out, just like nuclear barrage, wiping out everything. It's an escalation. Now, Carlos Maza made videos critical of Tucker Carlson and other conservatives and Fox News, and he repeatedly does it. Fine, by all means, you're entitled. Steven Crowder fired back. Absolutely, Crowder, you're entitled to do it. But Maza took it one step too far and went nuclear. And I don't want to throw back to this issue over and over again. I do have a story about the Vox Union coming up later. But the reason I bring this up is that it's a good show of how the escalation continues. Because it didn't end. The toxicity isn't ending with Carlos dropping a nuke on YouTube. We're now seeing, I kid you not, someone sent me an email. There's a dude who makes videos that's just like soothing noises. Like he'll record 10 hours of a rainforest. It's an amazing channel. It's called Stardust Vibes. It's called Stardust Vibes. And it's just like, man, there's this really amazing video. It's got 8 million views. It's a blizzard. And you see all the trees and you can see the mountains. And I'm like, man, that is no mountains, but there's like snow and cabins. And it's just blizzard for like 10 hours or something. And it's just awesome. It really is. It gives me that feeling of awe. So many people trapped in their cubicle, so many people trapped in the office, trapped at home, and you can watch videos like this. It's amazing. But this dude got stripped of his monetization. Even the channels that do, like, we need a channel like that. So again, I'm going to say Stardust Vibes because it is apolitical. It is just soothing, relaxing. That's the cure for the toxicity, being wiped out. Being wiped out in this wave of vitriol and hate. And that's what truly terrifies me. Look, man, when I see political creators and journalists getting hit by the Vox Adpocalypse, I'm like, man, you expect this. It's like, yup, the people, there are some left-wing activists and journalists who are documenting extremism getting hit, like Ford Fisher. They're just journalists. And their content gets removed because context is irrelevant. I expected that to happen. I don't want it to happen. I don't want Carlos to be banned. I don't want Vox to be banned. I don't want Crowder to be banned. He wasn't banned. I don't want anyone to be punished for saying things that are disagreeable. But then it escalates. He goes, take out Crowder. So he steps outside the bounds of criticism and just goes straight for the throat. Then what ends up happening is you get these journalists wiped out. And now we're at the point where the people who are actually trying to help end the toxicity are getting wiped out too. And so, you know, ultimately, I know it's kind of a deviation, but it's all in my mind with everything that's going on. I'll just say this. Don Lemon is right. The toxicity is getting worse. The cures for the toxicity are getting hit. And it's only going to get crazier. There's a video I covered the other day where some dude parks his car in the middle of the road, gets out and starts attacking Trump supporters. That's how insane it's getting. And all of this started when social media came about. Because all of a sudden, everyone was outraged by everything all the time. Mostly people on the left, let's be real. And I think they're riled up by a lot of left-wing news meant to make them angry. It is what it is. So I don't want to repeat any old points. We'll just end there. Don Lemon, your show is absolutely liberal. He says he wants to quit. There's a petition that is an old petition. I don't know when it's from. But the petition is actually from a black man who feels like Don Lemon is doing them harm. So I'll just leave it there. You know, stick around. I got more segments coming up. The next video will be at 1 p.m. on this channel for those on the podcast. The arrangement will be different, but it'll be coming up soon. If you want to support my work, timcast.com/donate. And if you're listening on the podcast, just leave a good review because it really does help. And I will see you in the next story.